And how's it going?
Really good.
Congratulations, man.
Thank you.
Robbie really put a scare, I think.
Oh, no doubt. You know, he was definitely the guy I was looking to that was gonna be battling me. He's such a fast guy that I think with less rounds he does better. So just being just a final, I was expecting him somewhere in the last 200 to come up on me. It was just a matter of how I was gonna respond. And I actually think he went by me at one point and I kind of came back again that last like 10, 20 meters. So, you know, obviously we have a great U.S. team going into Worlds next week, and just hopefully he won't be my prelim.
Is it a weird feeling for you? You've been sort of unchallenged in most of your races this year to have him right on your shoulder.
Yeah. I mean, it was obviously a good feeling. That's what you want in racing, you know, bring out the best in each other. You know, having him go by me, it's probably the first time actually someone went by me this whole year. I've been just in the front going by other people. So, definitely kind of stops your momentum at that time because I felt pretty good, but I was happy the way I responded, and that just kind of shows my strength right now. Just kind of carrying this momentum into World Indoors.
What was going through your head when you realized he was right next to you?
Well, when he was right on my shoulder, like, I was like, all right, here we go. But then he actually went by, and that's when I was like, I hope there's not another guy on his shoulder. So, like, you know, there was two guys that were going by me. Then I found myself not even on the team. And so I kind of, without looking at the board and kind of glancing over, it was just a matter about digging deep and just kind of looking past that finish line. That's what I had to do. It was a super, super choppy race. I would say more than in recent years. You know, last U.S. Indoor Championship, I don't think it was this physical. I think about three or four times, I kind of felt myself feeling like I was getting tripped up. I even glanced back at whoever was behind me, just because I was like, dude, this is like the third time now, you know? And that was all in the last three laps. So that kind of, you know, makes it a little more difficult when you're trying to wind up a little bit. So, I'm just really, really happy with my strength right now. I mean, I think anything, it doesn't really show how sharp I am, but how strong I am. So,
when you went by him there on the home straight the last time, did you think that was the win?
Yeah.
Over, or did you think there was one more? He had one more?
I mean, it was literally in the last like 20 meters, so I don't think any of us had any more moves at that point. I mean, we pretty much showed all of our cards by that point. I didn't even know necessarily if I had another move until I did it, you know, when I was giving myself all I had. But then once I had him go by me, you know, it was like, dude, come on, man. I got to keep this undefeated streak going into World Indoors. So I just kind of dug in again. And like I said, it's just a testament to my strength right now. Very, very strong. So
2 years in a row, you ran the world leading indoor time in the mile. This year was even faster. What kind of shape do you think you're going to be in for August?
I'm excited. I don't know necessarily what type of shape. It's just kind of all about getting the right race. But certainly 3:48 shape, I would imagine. I mean, for the full mile. 15, you know, definitely sub 3:30. I'm already ahead of where I was last year, and those are the times I put up, 3:50 and 3:30. So, but like I said, you know, this year it's all about championships, you know, Olympic Games, the Olympic trials. And so if I don't PR at all, then I come away with medals this year, I think I'll be pretty happy with that. So.
How about next week, though, Matthew?
Next week, I don't know what Iguiter's doing, but Soleiman's obviously already ran 2:14 for the K, so he's going to be a challenge. Robbie Andrews again, there's obviously some Brits and a slew of other guys, so just got to make that final, really, and just kind of put myself in a good position like I've been doing all year. Well, looking at the schedule, I would have had to run a 3K last night, and then two more 3Ks the next week. So you're looking at three 3Ks in a span of 8-9 days, and I think that just caters more to a 5K guy right now. And after running 3:50 and seeing that I'm, you know, four on the all-time list ever, it's kind of silly to pass that up. But I just think the rounds will help me out next week, and that's kind of where we thought we're pointing our interest. It was what makes more sense for me meddling, and we thought it was going to be 15 instead of 3K.
With Robbie being so close to you, does that sort of worry you, or is that more just a credit to how fit he is right now?
I think that's just a credit to how fit he is. You know, you put us in a fast race like Milrose, you know, maybe I come away with a couple seconds, but in a championship race like this, you know, it's not about fast times. So everyone's going to be within their tents, and he's got probably one of the best kicks in that field. So I think he's just in great shape. And like I said, I think I'm coming away from this a little more confident, even though I almost lost just for the way I fought that last 10, 20 meters.
Last question about those finishes. It seems like you have an ability better than most to stay composed and run through the line when it's neck and neck like that. Where does that come from?
Just strength, man. I think, you know, in the 15, I train with all these 5K, 10K guys. I just think that's, at that point, it's how much you want it. and I wanted this incredibly much. Like I said, I had a kind of an undefeated streak going this indoor season that I've had in the back of my head, and I wanted to kind of keep that momentum going. So definitely something I was thinking that last 10, 20 meters.
Thanks.